house, a beautiful day to worship Him, a beautiful day just to rest in His presence. A couple of announcements we want to bring to your attention today. One, this is Alabaster Offering Month. On February 27th, we'll receive our Alabaster Offering. That goes to build buildings and hospitals and parsonages and churches around the world. And in the back, you'll see the big blue box that's back there. That is just a reminder to us that that is taking place this week. Many of you probably have an Alabaster box sitting on your dresser or somewhere, or you have some other device collecting change so that you can place it in this Alabaster Offering. But if you need a box, there are some back there. Feel free to take one. Also, if you're interested in being a member of our church, we're doing a membership class following the service today, so we'll be meeting back in the classroom, the first classroom on your right, after the worship service during the Bible study time. So if you're interested, feel free to touch base with me on that. Also, the ladies are starting a new book study. It's on Heaven by Randy Alcorn. And so if you'll see Kim Cook, she has the information regarding that study. They meet on Mondays at 11 o'clock here at the church. Also, we are beginning a men's Bible study on Saturdays. We had our first meeting yesterday. About 10 of us were there. Had a wonderful time together. We're going to be studying from Tony Evans, Kingdom Men Rising. And so, Dave, would you just share that video with us this morning? And it'll be just a taste of what we're doing on Saturdays.
Successfully and to be crowned as a king. But many checkers don't make it to the other side because they've gotten jumped in the process. Every man has been created by God to become a kingdom man. But there's an enemy afoot to knock you off the board through sin, through rebellion, through failure, through things that on a journey to find out how you can still get your crown. In the midst of family disintegration, in the midst of social decline, God is calling men. He's calling you and me to man, stand up and rise up as His kingdom.
Hint at what God is doing and that He wants to work in our lives as men to help us become kingdom men who make an influence and a difference in the world around us. And so we invite you to come next Saturday, 8 o'clock here at the church. We're going to have breakfast. We have a wonderful time eating together and then sharing from God's Word together and going through the study together. If you would like a book, we have a couple books, a couple Bible study books still available. If you'll see Daryl there in the church office, but Daryl can get those for you. Daryl Kasnick is going to be leading us. It's going to be a wonderful time as we just simply get into God's Word as men and see what God is calling us to do. There's other announcements that are in your folder as well. You'll take notice of those that are there. I invite our praise team to come. Let's stand together. We're going to prepare to worship the Lord this morning. Heavenly Father, we thank You today. We thank You that You love us. We thank You that You've called us to something greater, something better. You've called us to be people who are serving You because of Your great love for us. And so, Lord, as we worship today, we just pray that You draw Your Holy Spirit, draw us close, speak to our hearts. Help us, Lord, to hear Your voice and to know of Your love. In Jesus' name.
To the lowest hell.
scripture in Romans where the scripture tells us that God demonstrated his love for us in this, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. He didn't wait for us to clean ourselves up. He didn't wait for us to get our act together. While we were still sinners, Jesus went to the cross and gave his life that we might have eternal life and a relationship with God. That is amazing grace that God gives us. Let's sing about that.
Thank you.
prepared for us, that our sin is forgiven and we can enter the presence of God. And one of the benefits of being in the presence of God is that He ever prays for us. He ever intercedes for us. And we can come before the throne of grace to receive mercy and help in our time of need. So we want to go to prayer this morning. I'm going to mute my mic so that I can speak and share things today. It is so good to have Melody with us. She has been battling COVID. God has brought her through, and she's here with us today. We just praise the Lord for God's healing touch upon her today. We want to continue to pray for several others that are battling through COVID. Paul Gilbert, that's Judy Pratt's brother. Also for baby Rilo, who's doing well. She's home. God has brought her through. We thank the Lord for that. She still has several healing needs there. We continue to lift her up in prayer. Also for Debbie, is it Sayers? Is that correct? Sue, Debbie Sayers?
Miles.
Okay. I told everybody today, I left my brain at home, so I need reminded from time to time. Debbie Miles, I want to pray for her today. Continue to lift her up in prayer. Also, Chris Kowiak has been diagnosed with COVID. He's on his third day and has requested that we pray for him. So let's lift Chris and his family in prayer today as well. Also, Dan Neal, who's a pastor in Cedar Ridge. Dan is just in that process where he has no energy, and he's trying to carry out ministry and just needs God's healing touch there. There's other needs here as well. I want to continue to pray for Zoe, to pray for Brecken as she hosts this worship night, for Anika Hobble, for Judy Russillo, for baby Kai, who's having surgery on February the 9th, to rearrange the inside of his heart. Guess what, I don't say that until he has chambers will work correctly. And so I want to pray for him. Also for Anna Leah, who has been going through chemo and leukemia. Olivia Gonzalez, who is facing stage 4 breast cancer in her lungs. Kim's supervisor, who's had a death in her family. I want to pray for her children. For Selena, for Crystal, for Porter. Just a number of needs that we pray for here as well. Also this week, Kim is going to have some, this seems so minor compared to some of these other things. Is going to have carpal tunnel surgery on her hand, which is her right hand. So she loses her right hand, which means I've become her right hand. And so be praying for her as good that everything goes smoothly. Again, that seems so minor compared to all these other things that we're talking about here. Also, the Pastor Terry Hendricks family, who passed away from COVID here just this last week. His service was last Saturday. Be praying for the Delta Church, for Karen and the family, and for the Delta Church as they move forward from this. Are there other needs this morning you just want to share with us before we go to prayer?